It takes courage to walk with ghosts, but that's what those who survived Auschwitz did today, laying wreaths at the camp's wall of death. It also takes courage to recall such horrors in front of a watching world. That's Sheva Dagan sharing the indignity of having her head shorn. A criminal hand took my crown of hair away, she said, and turned me into a sad and pitiful creature. No longer. Testimony after testimony punched right through time, unearthing sorrow, but plenty of anger, too, that anti-Semitism has been allowed to rise again.
People didn't learn, and it's very sad for me to see that we're starting all over again. My whole family is destroyed.
Canada's Eva Scheinblum was 16 when she arrived at Auschwitz, the only member of her family to survive.
I really didn't want to come here, but I wanted to be a witness, so people will see me, maybe.
See, over there is a kitchen.
Johnny Jablon, 94, is another Canadian orphaned by Auschwitz.
How do you feel?
I'm talking about different person, right? Because if I would talk about me, I couldn't.
His grandson Daniel is traveling with him, although he has trouble keeping up.
I know you're 47, but we have 90-year-olds with us, you know.
This is your mother, who was murdered here, as you can see.
Passing the torch of memory onto the next generation,
who was murdered where, do you remember?
Has become imperative for the survivors. As night fell, the world leaders who gathered here walked the train tracks that carried so many to their deaths and pledged the same. Margaret Evans, CBC News, at Auschwitz-Birkenau.